good stuff. And so when I was about 13, 14, you know, I was a big blues purist. And then I did a tour with, my brain is, I'm losing it, Captain Beefheart, that's right. No wonder I'm losing it. 1967, I mean, Captain Beefheart, you know, it wasn't, you know, there'd be some brain cells on that tour. But it was very creative, you know, and so I went home and said, I've got to be creative with the blues and, you know, rock it up and do something good with it. Not good, but, you know. So I went home, I was still living with my parents at the time, you know, so I went into the bedroom and I put all my Muddy Waters records on and I worked, I took a little bit of this, took a little bit of that. I met Buddy not so long afterwards, maybe 69, in this country, and I thought he'd be very excited because the record was quite a smash, you know, on the underground scene. And he said, "You stole my song." We didn't steal anything, we showed in the record, and he was credited and everything. But I think it's pretty, you know, it was weird back then, I think, for the guys to the older school to, you know, to hear their songs being done in a new way, you know. And actually it reminds me, I hear lots of really nice stories from people from, that were told by people like Muddy and everything, and about Sourdough and bands like that. And the older school guys were so generous, it was unbelievable, you know. There's no jealousy or anything. That was fantastic. Let's do Muddy's song now. It's called Louisiana Blues.
Yeah!
Thank you.
Thank you. bass guitar, Pat DeSalvo.
Bass guitar, Pat DeSalvo. On the drums, Garnet Grimm from Syracuse, New York.
Everybody, very grateful. How about it? Over 50 years this year, one of the pioneers of British blues. Just a kid. Yeah! Cowboy Brown.